Music ambassadors.
Hi, I'm Ely.
Hi, I'm Ewan.
Hi, I'm Madeline.
Hi, I'm Lelio.
Hi, I'm Ramine, and I'm a senior music ambassador.
Hi, I'm senior music ambassador Olivia.
Thank you, Mackenzie, for that lovely collection of Christmas songs on the bagpipes. Next up, we have Alex, who's singing a Christmas song.
And as a
Huxley. She's an S3 pupil and a member of our senior choir.
Next up is Liam McGrath. He's playing Prelude in D minor on piano.
Session.
Next up is Christina McGillian playing Walk in the Air on the cello.
Christina for that beautiful performance and to Mr. Kelly for accompanying her. Next up is S4 pupil Ellie. She'll be performing O Holy Night. Thank you, Ellie, that was lovely. Next up, we have the brass group performing Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Oh.
grass group and their instructor, Mr. Cowley.
Next up is advanced higher pupil Maisie McCormack playing Castle in the Sky on piano.
Maisie for that wonderful piece.
Next up we have SD Pupil Iona Dunlop singing Last Christmas.
Thank you.
And very festive with the Christmas tree.
Next up we have our advanced higher pupil Amy. She'll be singing Somewhere Only We Know.
Somewhere only we know.
Thank you, Amy, that was lovely.
Next up, we have Junior Ambassador Ailey, who'll be playing Study in C on the guitar.
Thank you to our instructor, Mr. Bowen, for accompanying her.
Next up, we will hear from Class 3H1, who will be performing Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree.
Something a little bit different from our drama department. S3 people Megan and S2 people Harley have been working together with our drama teacher Miss Walker on a little skit called Turkeys of Christmas. Enjoy!
And Merry Christmas, and this is what my true love gave to me this Christmas. As you'll hear, I am not very impressed. On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree. Really? Look, I don't want to sound ungrateful or anything, but we live in a flat on the fifth floor. We don't even have a garden. In fact, I don't even like pears. They make me break out in a rash. I think we'd rather have some antihistamine cream instead. On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two turtle doves. Well, that's what he pretended he gave to me. What he actually did was stick a pair of wings onto a couple of turtles he got from the pet shop. Some species of turtles can live up to 150 years. I don't think my true love thought this one through. I don't think that at my age I'm prepared to make a 150-year commitment. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me three French hens. Well, that's what he says he's got for me. Apparently, the hens are stuck in customs in Cali awaiting quarantine or something. They should be cleared in a week or two. I just hope someone remembers to feed them. Otherwise, my Christmas present will be three dead hens, which isn't quite as romantic, unless, of course, you're a fox. On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me four calling birds. I excitedly tore off the wrapping paper to see a cage with four large, noisy parrots. As if it wanted to make it worse, my true love decided it would be funny to teach them some rather inappropriate phrases. My mum is not going to be happy with him. My gran's going to pop round for tea later, and I think she might learn some new words. On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me five golden rings. Oh yeah, now we're talking. Although they're a bit blind for me, this, but do you think Cash for Gold will accept them? Hang on. Wait a minute. They're plastic! Typical! If it was going to be cheap, he could have at least got me some jelly sweet rings. On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 6 geese a-laying. Well, how thoughtful. Not. Now I have 6 goose eggs to eat every day. I'm not sure that my stomach can take that many eggs in my diet. All my friends at school might want to keep their distance, if you know what I mean. On the 7th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 7 swans a-swimming. Wonderful! Now I can't even take a bath because I've got 7 swans swimming about in there. I really need the loo after eating all those goose eggs, but there is no way I'm going anywhere near those swans. I've heard that a swan can break your arm, although I've never actually heard of that happening to anyone. Whatever, I'm not taking any chances. On the 8th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 8 maids a-milking. I just hope they're not planning on bringing their cows with them. My mum's just had a new cream carpet laid in the front room, and I don't think even Vanish can get the stains out. I wonder if I've got time to put down some plastic sheets. Oh no, I think we're too late. 9th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 9 ladies dancing. He's only gone and invited Auntie Vera and our whole Zumba class round to do their Zumba class in our house. I just hope they've brought their own towels. They're all covered in sweat. That vinyl floor could be lethal if someone doesn't start mopping up soon. 10th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 10 lords leaping. Just when I thought I was going to have a nice, civilised afternoon of party games with the gentleman from Downton Abbey, my true love and his mates come round for a leapfrog competition. I better push the couch back so they don't wreck it. Look out for the cowpats! 11th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 11 pipers piping. Here we go again, another one to annoy Mum. She's been complaining about those calling birds every night of the week, and now we've got 11 bags of hot air squealing like they're being tortured. 12th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 12 drummers drumming. That's it, I've had enough. Just when I thought I couldn't sink any lower, I've now got thumping drum and bass constantly for all to hear. My mum's going to be so mad, she's just finished with the pipers. Better come warn them. Oh wait, there's a letter from my true love.
Dear Merry Christmas, I hope you enjoyed the thoughtful gifts that I bought for you this Christmas. I'm afraid to say that this next bit is quite an embarrassing thing to say, but it's been an expensive Christmas this year. I thought that next year I'll get you a nice pair of socks. I hope you don't mind. From your true love.
Mind? Why would I mind? Socks are the best Christmas present ever.
Well done to Megan and Harley for that great performance. Next up is Junior Ambassador Madeline, who'll be singing When You Believe from the Prince of Egypt.
Thank you.
Next up, we have advanced our pupil Ailey Murray, who has finally agreed to play piano at our very last concert, and she will be playing In the Bleak Midwinter. Wonderful performance. Good luck in your future, and we hope you continue to play the piano.
Next up, we have a performance from our senior choir, who have individually recorded their performances at home to make this possible. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Performance from the junior choir. Hopefully we'll be able to sing together in the next few months. Now 3F1 are going to perform the Wham classic Last Christmas.
We really miss performing live and we hope we can do it again soon.
For those of you who have been to our previous concerts, you may have noticed a tradition.
We always end the concert with Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas, and tonight is no exception.
Merry Christmas! Christmas.
Bye.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Have yourself a merry